The mission of the National Coalition for Cancer Survivorship is to advocate for quality cancer care for all Americans who are faced with a diagnosis. And NCCS does its work through in two different areas. One is in policy and one is in programs for patients who are facing a diagnosis. So the policy work happens largely in the DC area. We work to change regulations to best meet the needs of cancer patients. We participate in a number of venues, and we actually convene meetings with people in professional organizations, other advocacy groups, pharma, and a number of other stakeholders in the cancer community to actually talk about the issues that really will move forward our cause, which is quality cancer care. So changing regulations so that they're patient-centered, for instance. The other arena that we work in is in developing resources for patients. So I'm here at ONS and go to other venues working with healthcare professionals to educate them about our resources, which they can then hand off to their patients. We feel that you can change the policy environment all you want, or the community in which the environment in which the care takes place, but patients need to be activated to participate in their own care, helping participating in the decision-making process to really get the care that best meets their needs. There are a lot of decisions that need to be made when someone's diagnosed, and our resources help prepare them to be engaged in their care. So the Cancer Survival Toolbox is our flagship program. It's been around for 12 years. It was developed by a team of social workers and nurses and was based on some evaluations that we had done, some focus groups and surveys with healthcare professionals and with cancer patient survivors to identify what are the things that patients need when they're diagnosed so that they can best cope with their disease. And there are some basic skills that came out from that. And the toolbox is an audio resource that helps patients learn those skills. And then there's some special topics that have been added. So those basic skills are communication. You know, how do you communicate with your provider? How do you communicate with your family to talk about the issues and your concerns, your emotions, your problems, etc.? There's a program within the toolbox that addresses decision-making style, problem-solving, standing up for your rights. So there's these six basic skills that help people to, regardless of their cancer type, to advocate for themselves and to be engaged in their care. There have been some special topics that have been added over the years, and those include first steps for the newly diagnosed. And that really helps patients to orient themselves. You know, that's an overwhelming time when somebody's diagnosed, but first steps help someone to say, figure out, where do I go from here? There's a program within the toolbox for older persons looking at the comorbidities and how to handle and address those things. There's a program on finding ways to pay for care, living beyond cancer, and a program called Dying Well, which helps patients who are at the end stage of life and their disease to actually take some charge and control over that last stage, deal with some really practical matters, getting their papers in order, but also look, you know, finding hope for what's the quality of life I want at this last stage of my survivorship. So that's the toolbox in a nutshell. It comes with a resource guide. It can be downloaded from our website. But again, it's usable for all cancer types, and it's really a tool. You know, nurses, social workers, particularly nurses and doctors, you know, provide the clinical care for their patients. And the toolbox is a broad-based resource that they can give to any patient anywhere along the cancer continuum to provide that psychosocial support and help them to help their patients be their own best advocate. Our goals are really just to continue to expand our resource. I think the real challenging place for patients once they complete treatment is post-treatment and survivorships. But, you know, people have been talking about survivorship a long time. Our organization is about survivorship. We've been around for 25 years. And we see that there's a great need. There, more than 12 million survivors in the country, and their needs ought to be addressed. And our resources can help with that, but I think that anybody who's providing care to patients ought to be looking at how can I help transition my patient from my care to the primary care doc. And I've talked to many nurses today who have said, you know, we're looking to build a survivorship program, don't know where to begin. So we'd like to help with that. we hear from people who, you know, practitioners who say, well, we're done with treatment and our patients don't want to let go of us. And some providers don't want to let go of their patients, but their workload is such that they can't really continue to hang on to those patients who have completed treatment. So we're engaged in a collaboration called Journey Forward with ONS, UCLA Cancer Survivorship Center, WellPoint, and Genentech, and it's a software for oncologists to provide a treatment summary and a post-treatment survivorship plan. So our goal is to help get the word out about not just Journey Forward, but about care planning and survivorship care planning to healthcare providers and help them to recognize that really helps their patients move on and to look for late effects, secondary cancers, and what maintenance and what kind of screening should they undergo moving forward. Provides a lot of relief to the patient, also offers guidance to the primary care physician. So our goal, again, for the year is to continue to get the word out on the importance of patients being engaged in their care, being, you know, participating with their doctor in decision making, and looking at the long-term survival for the patient and how to best meet those needs. We have a gala, which you put on, like many other advocacy organizations, and we bring people together. We do have the Cancer Policy Roundtable, which takes place two times a year, and we bring together a really unique group of stakeholders. We bring in pharma companies, we bring in other advocacy groups, and as well as experts in either in research or providers in the around the country, and we convene at this meeting and we talk about topical issues like drug shortages, healthcare reform, other quality initiatives that are relevant. So that takes place twice a year, and it's one way for us to bring people together and push forward not just our message, certainly what's the reality out in the field. So that's always well received, and I think keeps the conversation going in the direction we need to be going in quality care. People can call us at our home office in outside of DC, 301-650-9127. Our website is www.canceradvocacy.org. We're welcome to take, people can leave us messages. We're happy to answer any questions people might have.